Good evening. You're watching Reporters Diary on the Eco of India's digital platforms. And before we move ahead with reports from our team, let me share with you the major points which are in news today evening. A day after the Nitish Kumar-led suspension retained power in Bihar, the state wing of BJP today made it clear that the JDU leader will continue to be the chief minister. Crediting Prime Minister Narendra Modi's welfare policies for NDA's victory in the state, Bihar BJP chief Sanjay Jaiswal said, all anti-incumbency claims have been negated by the mandate for a fourth term to the Nitish Kumar government. Jaiswal also said that the gap between the number of seats of BJP and JDU will have no impact on the ruling alliance dynamics in the state. And I quote, we are allies and equals. We have to run Bihar collectively, he said. After months of dialogues and negotiations between the armies, India and China are perhaps on the verge of a breakthrough in resolving the tense border standoff in eastern Ladakh. According to some authoritative sources, both sides have broadly agreed on a three-step process on disengagement of troops and withdrawal of weaponry from all major friction points in a time-bound manner. Moving on to OTT, films, audiovisuals, news and current affairs content on online platforms will now come under the domain of the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. This announcement was made by the Union Government. A notification issued by the Cabinet Secretariat on Tuesday night states that content made available by online providers such as Netflix will also come under the ministry. The notification signed by President Ramnath Kovind said the decision has been taken in exercise of the powers conferred by Clause 3 of Article 77 of the Constitution by amending the Government of India Allocation of Business Rules 1961, and it will come into effect immediately. The Shipping Ministry has now been renamed as Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways. The decision was taken days after Prime Minister Narendra Modi made an announcement to this effect. According to a notification issued by the Cabinet Secretariat, Maritime Shipping and Navigation, provision of education and training for the mercantile marines, lighthouses and lightships, administration of the ports, shipping and navigation, including carriage of passengers and goods on inland and national waterways will be under Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways. And one of the world's longest serving prime ministers, Bahrain's Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa has passed away. He was 84. Al Khalifa led the Bahrain government for decades and survived the 2011 Arab Spring protests, which demanded his ouster over corruption allegations. Without elaborating, the country's state-run news agency announced his death, saying he had been receiving treatment at the Mayo Clinic. So these are the major points we have in news, and now we move on to our team of reporters. I'm joined by Asmita and Riddhi. Asmita, what all happening?
Hi, Sophia. One disturbing news that has come from the Darjeeling Hills is that one JGM Binay Tamang faction supporter was attacked yesterday with sharp weapons by 2 persons who turned out to be supporters of JGM Bimal Gurung faction. And Safi, they were arrested by the police, and the Binay Tamang supporters was admitted to hospital with grievous injuries. And the incident has triggered tension in the hills as the Bimal Gurung faction is gaining strength in the hills. And Safi, just yesterday, the Patlebas party office of Bimal Gurung was reopened. That's all from my side, Safi.
All right, yes. Riddhi, what all happening?
Hi, Safi. Starting with the good news, not only for the people of the City of the Joy, but for the entire state as well. People will now have an alternative ways to reach their destinations. It's a relief mainly for the people who stays in the suburbs as the local train services resume in West Bengal after 7 months of lockdown. The railway authority is maintaining a strict vigil, and passengers were found flouting the COVID-19 protocols. The local train services under the jurisdiction of the Eastern and the Southeastern Railways resumed early in the morning. They were suspended in March following the COVID-19 outbreak. The railway authorities have requested the passengers to conform the COVID-19 protocol and made them mandatory of wearing masks for entering the stations or trains. However, the city doctors are extremely concerned over the flouting of the COVID-19 safety norms in the suburban trains in Kolkata and other parts of the West Bengal today, warning that the pandemic situation would deteriorate. Dr. Anirban Dalui, a public health specialist, said that the problem is that those who are asymptomatic or have mild symptoms are traveling on the trains, risking the lives of the people who are not taking proper precautions. Now, in another development, the BJP gives finishing touches to its Bengal Assembly election strategy with lessons from Bihar as the West Bengal Assembly elections due in April, May next year. As the party sources say today, the BJP, after bagging 74 seats, has emerged as the second largest party in the state with a tally much higher than its ally JDU's 43. The Saffron Party has set a target of winning more than 200 seats in the 294 strong Bengal Assembly. With Bihar done and dusted, they have now shifted their focus in Bengal, with sense 42 MPs to the Lok Sabha, two more than Bihar, they said. The BJP National General Secretary and the party's West Bengal minder, Kailash Vijayvargiya, had on Tuesday asserted that the victory in the states will be much bigger as the party will storm to power with a two-third majority. Vijayvargiya also said that the people of West Bengal are fed up with the misrule of the TMC and they want a change. BJP State Chief Dilip Ghosh echoed him, saying, after Bihar, it will be West Bengal for the BJP. The ruling TMC, however, mocked the Saffron Party's target of winning more than 200 seats in the state. The TMC MP and spokesperson Saugata Roy said, as far as coming to power in West Bengal is concerned, the BJP is still living in the fool's paradise. The party will lose deposits in most of the seats. That's all I have from my side.
All right, Asmita Riddhi, thank you so much for joining Reporters Diary. Viewers, this is all we have in Reporters Diary this evening. Thanks for watching.